Praise the Lord, Saints. This is Evangelist Deborah Tate again. We're still talking about bread baskets. Welcome to my website. You're probably asking, what is a basket? Often you will find baskets being mentioned in the Bible, especially in the Old Testament. We know that baskets were used for many things and that they came in all types of shape and sizes. And quite often when the Bible speaks of baskets, the Bible is talking about a type of container that for the most part was used for carrying food. Baskets were a common containers made from reeds or bulrushes, wigs, or other neutral materials. They varied widely in their strength and their shape and their purpose, although they usually had handles of some sort, and sometimes they had lids. They were commonly used for bread and fruit, and due to their woven construction, most of them, not all of them, but most of them were not waterproof. Baskets were often used back then for birds and also for small animals. If you have your Bibles real quickly, turn them to Genesis chapter 40. We're coming out of verses 16 through 18, and we're going to be coming out of the King James Version. Verse 16. When the chief baker saw that the interpretation was good, he said unto Joseph, I also was in my dream, and behold, I had three white baskets on my head. And in the uppermost basket there was of all manner of baked meats for Pharaoh, and the birds did eat them out of the basket upon my head. In this case, it looks like the basket is not going to be so much for food as it will be for his head. To give you a quick summary of what is going on here, Joseph is in jail. His brothers threw him in a pit. He ended up at Potiphar's house, whose wife tried to seduce him, and then he didn't do anything, and he ends up in jail, and he's got a butler, and he's got a baker, and they're both in jail with him. The butler is the wine taster for the king, and the baker does what he does. He makes bread. Both of them are in there. The butler has a dream. Joseph gives him a favorable interpretation of the dream. Hey, you're going to be restored, you're going back, and you're going to perform your duties before the king. But unfortunately, he doesn't give a good interpretation of the dream to the baker who bakes the bread. He's going to end up beheaded with his head in the basket where birds of prey are going to eat. Scavenger birds are going to eat. Verse 18, and Joseph answered and said, this is the interpretation thereof. The three baskets are 3 days. Yet within 3 days shall Pharaoh lift up thy head from off of thee, and shall hang thee on a tree, and the birds shall eat thy flesh from off of thee. And it came to pass the 3rd day, which was Pharaoh's birthday, which he made a feast unto all his servants, and he lifted up the head of the chief butler and of the chief baker among his servants. And he restored the chief butler unto his butlership again, and he gave the cup into Pharaoh's hands. But it didn't happen with the baker. He ended up dying. He ended up being hung on a tree, and the birds end up eating his mind. The word of God is considered to be bread. Even Jesus, when he was out on the wilderness, he said to the devil, when the devil was trying to tempt him to eat, he said, turn these stones into bread. And Jesus said, man does not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of God. What the word of God wants us to know is that not only do we need natural food, bread, which is the staple of life, the necessity of our bodies to have it. It maintains all kinds of nutrition. But we also need the word of God, which is considered to be bread. Just like our natural bodies have to eat, our spiritual bodies have to eat too. That's the part of us you can't see. It has to eat. And it has to eat what some people call soul food. there needs food for the soul. And we get this nutrition through the Word of God. And when we are fed the bread of life, when we partake of it, then we don't have to worry about birds of prey picking our brains, because we have faith and confidence in knowing that God is a provider and that He is able to do exceedingly and abundantly all that we can think or ask. But when we don't study our word, when we don't study to show ourselves approved, work men and women who need not be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth, we will find out that Satan will somehow have our minds in a container, in a basket, and he will allow his prey, his birds. Birds sometimes represent in the Bible demonic entities that are out to cause stress and worry on your mind. And that's what they want to do. They want to cause stress and worry in your mind. And they pick with your mind. God doesn't want us to live like that. But he wants us to depend upon the Word of God, which will strengthen our bodies and strengthen our mind. I'm going to end this with this. It is a known fact that a student cannot do well in school unless he had the proper nutrition. Healthy eating means a healthy mind. Well, it's the same in the natural realm. It's the same in the spiritual realm. Healthy eating, God's Word, brings healthy mind. My name is Evangelist Deborah Tate. I'm with Royal Diadem Ministries. This is our Breadbasket series. Thank you for joining in. And remember, you are a crown of glory in the hand of thy God. Keep clicking in here. And I hope we've been a blessing. God bless you.